10 rare animals you've never seen before. The world is a place full of different species and animals, widely documented in encyclopedias and showcased on television programs. And yet, till this day, we continue to discover new ones. From the tiniest insect to the biggest of mammals, we never cease to be amazed. But some of these species are so rare, most of us have never even seen them. And this brings us up to our topic for today. Hello, and welcome to Info Junkie TV, where we teach you all about the world's weirdest and most fascinating things. Today, we bring you 10 of the rarest animals you've probably never seen before. So be sure to hit the subscribe button and click that notification bell for more videos like this one. Number 1. The Pika. These small mountain-dwelling mammals are said to be native to Asia and North America, although they were last spotted in the Xinjiang region of China. Pikas have a very round body, short limbs, and an even coat of fur. They have no tail and mostly resemble a rabbit, a close relative, although their ears are shorter and rounded. They are about 6 to 9 inches long and are also known for their high-pitched alarm call. Pikas prefer to live on cold rocky mountainsides where numerous crevices are available for shelter. They can't live in temperatures over 25.5 degrees Celsius, and only about 1,000 or so remain of this species. To take in more nutrition, like rabbits, pikas usually eat their feces after they've produced it. Yum, right? Some specific pika species, like the collared pika, which are mostly found in America, are known to keep dead birds in their burrows to store as food in the winter, although the other species are mostly herbivores. Pikas usually have litters of 5 or more based on their dwelling place and have a lifespan of around 7 years. Number 2. The Peruvian Spider Monkey. The Peruvian spider monkey is one of the largest primates in South America. It can weigh up to 10 kilograms and is around 2 feet tall, with a prehensile tail that can grow up to 3 feet long. Its long limbs and tail are the main reason behind its name, since they make it look like an actual spider when it moves. The prehensile tail serves as somewhat of a fifth limb from which they can dangle and move through the branches. The Peruvian spider monkeys usually live in groups of 20 or 30, but aren't always together simultaneously. They mostly like to eat fleshy fruits, but will adapt their diet according to the resources available. When ripe fruits are scarce, they tend to veer towards small rodents, insects, or leaves. During the fall season, females usually separate from the group to give birth. Peruvian spider monkeys are mostly independent by the time they're 10 months old and have a lifespan of around 20 years. Unfortunately, since the 1970s, this species has seen a decline of over 50% in their population and is currently listed as endangered on the IUCN Red List of Threatened Species. Number 3. The Saola. The Saola is so rare, it's actually referred to as the Asian unicorn for this reason, as well as for the two horns on its head and the white spots on its face. The species was actually first described in 1992 in the Vu Quang Nature Reserve, thanks to the discovery of its remains by a Vietnamese survey team that was sent there to examine the biodiversity of the place. The first photograph of a living Saola wasn't taken until 7 years later in 1999 by a camera trap set by the Vietnamese government's Forest Protection Department. From what we know so far, this bovine mammal can only be found in the Annamite range of Vietnam and Laos, and has only been sighted a total of 4 times by scientists in the wild. Number 4. Darwin's Fox. Named after Charles Darwin, the scientist who first discovered the species in 1834, this fox from the Lycolepix genus, which is actually closer to wolves than foxes, is an endangered specimen only found in 2 parts of the world, Chile and the Chiloé Island. The animal has a head-to-body length of approximately 19 to 23 inches and a 7 to 10 inch long tail. Originally thought to be part of the gray fox subspecies, further genetic analysis showed that Darwin's fox was distinctly different, not only in behavior but in appearance as well. Having shorter legs, a darker fur, a broader skull, and a different shape of jaw and premolar occlusion. The species prefers open areas, unlike most Lycolepix, and is mostly omnivore, eating live animals and fruit. Number 5. The Vaquita. The vaquita, or little cow in Spanish, is a porpoise endemic species native to the Gulf of California, With a length of 140 to 150 centimeters, it is the smallest of all aquatic mammals. It can be easily recognized due to its physical appearance. The vaquita has a small body and a uniquely tall and triangular dorsal fin. Its head is round and it has no protruding beak. It is mostly gray in color and has visible black patches around its eyes and mouth. Females usually have larger heads, a longer body, and wider flippers, although the height of the dorsal fin is more prominent in males. Sadly, due to bycatch from illegal totoba fishing, this species is on the brink of extinction, with researchers estimating the population at fewer than 10 individuals. Number 6. The Hooded Grebe. Found in the southern region of Argentina, the hooded grebe is a medium-sized aquatic bird that grows about 13 inches in length. This bird is mostly known for its unusual dance moves, made to attract its significant other during breeding season. This black and white bird is mostly found in isolated lakes, both bitter and saline. It requires aquatic vegetation during mating season to build its nest. This vegetation is also home to various insects and larvae, which the bird uses to feed itself and its chicks once they've hatched. However, their reproduction rate is very low, with the average number of young per adult being only 0.2 per year. Thankfully, the resources needed for them to survive are abundant, making the adult mortality rate quite low and thus somewhat conserving the species despite the lack of success in breeding. Unfortunately, it has still made the current list of critically endangered species in the IUCN, mainly due to the threat caused by the American mink. One single mink can take out a whole colony of grebes. Number 7. The Aardwolf. This insectivorous mammal is so shy, it's extremely rare to spot one in the wild, even though its population is in no danger of extinction. Native to eastern and southern Africa, the word aardwolf in Afrikaans means earth wolf, although the species is said to be part of the hyena family, not the wolf. The aardwolf basically looks like a thin-striped hyena, although its muzzle is more slender. It has a yellowish fur, lined with black stripes and a distinct mane running down its neck and back. During confrontations, the mane is raised to make the animal seem bigger. Unlike many of its carnivora relatives, the aardwolf only eats insects and larvae. The animal has a long, sticky tongue that is adapted to be tough enough to withstand insect bites. The aardwolf is mainly nocturnal and prefers to hide in burrows during the day. Number 8. Durell's von Syra. This carnivorous mammal native to Madagascar is one of the most endangered species in the world. It is a marsh-dwelling animal that closely resembles a mongoose and feeds on crustaceans and mollusks, unlike its cousin whose diet mainly consists of insects. Durell's von Syra is characterized by its prominently padded feet, reddish underparts, and its visibly strong teeth, which help it open or break the hard parts of its prey. It was named after the Durell Wildlife Conservation Trust after they discovered the species by chance during their survey of bamboo lemurs. Number 9. The Metallic Tarantula. Here's another IUCN critically endangered species, also known as the Goofy Sapphire Ornamental Tree Tarantula. Quite the mouthful, don't you think? This spider was first discovered in 1899 and then rediscovered in Andhra Pradesh, India in 2001. Due to habitat destruction, they are very rare to spot and live only on an area of less than 100 square kilometers. They can reach very high prices on black markets because of how rare they actually are. The metallic tarantula is also very hard to study, and scientists are yet to discover the reason behind its bright blue color. What we do know is that the species live in holes found in tall trees, in which they create a symmetrical funnel webs and mostly feed on flying insects. They are photosensitive and will most likely flee if a light is shined upon them, although they might bite if provoked. Number 10. The Angel Shark. This ray-looking hybrid is part of the Squatinidae family. Known for their flattened bodies and broad pectoral fins, they usually inhabit seabeds at depths of around 150 meters, where they camouflage themselves in the sand. Unlike other benthic fish, the angel shark does not pump out water from the oropharyngeal cavity. It uses the gill flaps located under its body instead. The population has declined dramatically since the 1980s, when people started fishing and eating these animals, and is now on the IUCN list of critically endangered species. The shark may appear harmless, but like any other animal, if provoked, it will attack. Its powerful jaws and sharp teeth can inflict some really painful lacerations. So if you ever get the chance to be near one of them, make sure you don't grab their head nor the tail. We've reached the end of our video, folks. Thank you for watching Info Junkie TV. We hope you infomaniacs enjoyed our list and discovered some new species with us. Be sure to do some more research if you want to help in the restoration of these species. You'll find many nonprofits that support these causes. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up for more fascinating content and make sure to hit subscribe. While you're here, why don't you leave a comment and tell us what the most surprising animal on this list, or tell us if we missed any. That's all for now, Infomaniacs, and we'll see you real soon.